Shadow Throne. You're an unthinkable war.
Holy Terror is humanity's birth world. It is the site of the Imperial Palace, the seat of the God Emperor's Golden Throne, and its loss would likely doom the human race. When the taint of gene-stealer cultists was discovered amongst Terra's northern polar archaeologies, therefore, the Imperial response was swift and brutal. It was only chance that saw the cult of the pauper princes discovered on Terra, in an age when humanity suffered one disaster after another. The detection of this latest peril was a blessing from the Emperor. An underhive stim deal had gone sour, triggering a violent turf war between rival gangs in the depths of archaeology Phariseum Nagilis. When local Adeptus Arbites forces responded to the escalating violence, their quarry retreated into the long disused mag transit network dug into the Arcology's foundations. It was a transgression. Neither the fleeing gangers nor the majority of those who pursued them would live to rue. From out of the subterranean gloom spilled degenerate xenocultists in their hundreds. Like an insect hive kicked by an unsuspecting passerby, the undertunnels spewed fierce defenders who swarmed and slaughtered the trespassers. All this may have still gone unnoticed, but for the heroism of a single arbitrator squad who managed to escape above their repressor transport and stay alive long enough to transmit the word of their plight. Before howling pursuers finally surrounded and slaughtered them, vid feeds were exploded of the catastrophe to their precinct fortress 10 levels up. The transmission was enough to trip multiple data snoops, seeding into the Terran cognital architecture by agents of the Inquisition. Even before the precinct's senior judge had time to assess the threat and decide upon a course of action, other Imperial agents were moving. Despite its paramount importance, humanity's throne world does not house the same kind of defensive garrisons boasted by many of the more far-flung planets. The Sol system is, of course, massively garrisoned and fortified against threats from without. Yet, to even voice aloud the preposterous suggestion that corruption could lurk within the shadow of the Emperor's throne is considered heresy by many. Coupled with hidebound tradition and a fear of betrayal whose source is lost beneath the dust of millennia, this notion has long made complex the raising or stationing of Astra Militarum soldiery upon Terra soil. Even the Imperial Fist Space Marine chapter, who have the singular honour of recruiting from the throne world itself, restrict their presence largely to the mighty star fortress Phalanx that hangs in high orbit. For all this, Terra is far from defenceless. It is in the nature of the Imperium to accrue layer upon layer of outdated strictures and contradictory bureaucracy. Those who coordinate its defense are practiced in walking a line between the tangled thickets of red tape towards their duty's fulfillment. Coordinated from the shadows by Lord Inquisitor Ichabel Vasmir, agents of the alien-hunting Ordo Xenos moved into action. Regiments of Inquisitorial Tempestus Scions emerge from secret low-orbit platforms aboard Valkyrie dropcraft. Embedded Inquisitorial warbands shed their cover identities and began to hunt. The covert prioris of the Sisters of Battle mustered fanatical missions and dispatched them north with all haste. Sequestrian runes flashed up on all Adeptus Arbites cogitator screens throughout the polar archaeologies, informing many thousands of armoured enforcers that they were now under the direct command of the Emperor's Inquisition, and they should arm themselves and prepare for deployment accordingly. With remarkable swiftness, the disparate forces assembled by Inquisitor Vasmir moved to contain the threat. Level by level, archaeology by archaeology, total lockdown was imposed. Armoured shutters rattled into position, sanctified bulkheads and level gates sealed themselves as the spire militars of noble houses hastened to their positions. Weaponized servo skulls prowled Commercia, Industria, and Habitation districts in their millions, and woe betide any unauthorized soul who caught their crimson gaze. Sprawling library sacks and scriptorums were sealed, trapped legions of shocked administratum scriveners within. Pilot beacons around the mountainous Wyvern's Gate spaceport turned crimson, warding thousands of void ships away, sending billions of pilgrims, traders, and labourers into holding patterns that might well trap them for years to come. Meanwhile, vermilion encrypted requests flashed through blessed conduits to the most powerful assets of all. These were not the imperious orders for compliance issued to everyone else. These were situational appraisals, threat cognition data sums, and respectful requests for aid. They were received within the shadowy temples of the Officio Assassinorium and behind the towering bulwarks of the Imperial Palace, and there they were gravely considered.